Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 12.1.1 Beta 3 has been out for a few days, and I've been using it on my XS Max and some other phones as well, and I also did a YouTube community poll, and many of you responded, so I appreciate that. We'll talk about that more in a moment. Now, the first thing I wanted to go over is one thing I missed when I did the actual What's New video of 12.1.1 Beta 3 is there's a little change on the iPad or an update to fix an issue with FaceTime. So if we go into FaceTime on the iPad and make a call, if you're making a FaceTime call, you'll see we now have the ability to flip the camera where we didn't before. So they've brought this back to the iPad. So that's a great thing. Now, other than that, there wasn't a whole lot new going on, but there were a lot of bugs people experienced in this particular one. In fact, I've had apps crash. I've had things lock up. I've had things just not work properly. Maybe I'll go into the camera and it immediately goes out. Or just weird little issues all over the place. Maybe I'll open an app, it'll crash, then I can reopen it and it works fine. But for some reason, there were some really weird issues with this beta. And I'm not the only one. Many of you had issues, but let's talk about battery life and then we'll talk about the other issues that most people were having. So if we go into the battery here, we'll wait for it to load. And again, battery life on this one's 100%. Don't be concerned if it's lower. The updates won't necessarily make it lower, and I don't think Apple has that algorithm nailed down. Some people will have it go down to, say, 97, then they'll update, and it will go back up. So that tells me right there that something's screwy with that. It's not accurate, so I just really ignore it at this point. Now, my actual battery life has not been great, and on a XS Max, this should be really good. And over the last 10 days, you'll see these are the 3 days that I used it on this beta, and then I used it on other phones as well, the XR. And you'll see I was only getting about 3.5 hours of screen on time. In fact, last night before I went to bed, I had about 20 to 30% battery life left. We're at 99 right now, but I had 20 to 30% battery life left, and I'd only had about 3.5 hours of screen on time. So it hasn't been great, about 4 hours there. It should be about 5 on this phone, 4 to 6, depending on what you're doing. And you'll see 27% of that was YouTube on that day, Twitter yesterday. So nothing really crazy going on. I'm not using games. I am using it for a lot of video, 45 minutes of YouTube on that day. But messages and everything else, nothing really absurd that should be causing huge battery drain. So that's an issue for me, and it was an issue for a lot of you. And most of you that had issues was reporting an issue with LTE. Now, LTE will always be on when you have Wi-Fi, unless you turn it off, of course. But people were reporting they were out and trying to use an app. So it could be any app, and I don't know if it's specific, because a lot of you reported this in a lot of different apps that LTE data just wasn't working. So that you were asking, when are they going to fix the LTE bug? And supposedly they fixed LTE in iOS 12.0.1 and 12.1 when they had Wi-Fi and LTE fixes. I haven't had any issues with Wi-Fi, but a lot of you said you had issues with LTE. And so I asked because I started hearing this and I thought, they can't still have problems with this because I haven't experienced it. But then a lot of you said you did. So they obviously need to fix something. And it's not just iPhone, the newer iPhones, it's a lot of iPhones. So maybe you'd go into an app, it just won't load. The app will load, but you can't connect anything, like there's no data connection. So that's something that they need to fix. Now let's take a look at what you had to say. So over the past 21 hours, 6.1K votes, so 6,100 votes. So I appreciate the feedback. And you'll see 26% of you said it was great, 4% terrible, 9% said okay, but some bugs, 12% said I use Android, and 48% said just show me the results, please. I probably should get rid of that since we're hoping that if you're on a beta, we have good feedback here. In hindsight, I should change this to I don't use betas instead of I use Android. So maybe in the future I'll do that. Now, as far as the responses, the last time I read this a few minutes ago, there was 106, so I've read them all, but let's take a look at the ones down at the bottom, and we'll go through some of these. And like I said, now, the reason I'm not talking about these older phones right here and newer phone, the XR, 5S, and 6S Plus, and all the other phones, it doesn't seem to be that there's any differences between them as far as this beta is concerned, other than some of them not having features such as the group FaceTime on some of the really older ones, but that's known already. But as far as the bugs, it doesn't seem to be specific to any one phone. It seems to be across all of them. So if you're worried about bugs, don't upgrade to a beta ever. That's usually a really bad idea, unless there's a specific fix you're looking for that you're willing to deal with the other bugs in order to get that fix. Now, if those resolve your issues, you'll be good, but otherwise I wouldn't install a beta normally. Now, as you can see here, a lot of people were saying it's great or you never use betas. Seems good on my XS Max. I've not seen any issues. Battery is still good. Not able to use mobile data. And here's what I was talking about before. A lot of you were saying this. Wi-Fi on the Wi-Fi status bar shows LTE even though it's on Wi-Fi. I don't know if that's a bug necessarily. Waiting for public version on iPhone 7. Battery life is terrible. Battery life has been terrible. You need to be up how to get beta update. I normally link that in the description of how you can become a developer or public beta tester. So you can do that pretty simply if you really want to try it. But I wouldn't try it out if you're worried about bugs on iPhone XS Max, but phone call signal is not exceeding 1 bar. I haven't had any signal issues, but a lot of people were saying LTE bugs. Now the next one says, I have an iPhone XS and I'm currently on iOS 12.1 and I've noticed a lot of bugs like stuttering. I really hope this will be fixed soon. Some of those are in apps. Some of those are the operating system itself. So I have an iPhone 6 running this beta version. Sometimes it gets freeze while scrolling, battery backup 4 hours, 15 minutes. On continuous usage, GPS also running. That's actually not bad. Even with 80% battery health, I might want to consider getting that battery replaced before the end of the year since it's only $30 at an Apple store until then. The only bug I've encountered is the settings lag or freeze every now and then. Other than that, it's fine. Battery and speed still great. I still have that freeze occasionally. I didn't in the previous beta. I'd love to use the beta, but I'm scared of the bugs. Don't use one then. Definitely avoid it. I'm on the official build and I feel the phone isn't as buttery smooth as it was on iOS 12. I've seen people resonate my views here. Could you confirm? No, it doesn't fix it. Not at all. Hopefully, now it depends on the phone. It's pretty smooth overall on the newest phones. I only get 3 hours of screen on time on my 7 Plus with 100% battery. Yeah, me too. Let's see. Don't have betas since updated to iOS 12. My phone is running hot. If your phone's running hot, sometimes this is normal. There's things going on in the background and it's going to be warm. If it gets too hot, it will tell you it's too hot and it needs to cool down. Apple is very sensitive to heat regulation. They do that with the batteries as well, even while you're charging wirelessly. If it gets too warm, it actually pulls the voltage back so that it doesn't get too hot and can prolong the life of the battery. XS Max, apps are struggling to load on LTE. There's another one. Music messes up all the time, especially in a moving vehicle. It sporadically can't find results when I search for music. Actually, now that you mention the music part, I have that as well. Sometimes it doesn't find the music and it's there. When I'm connected with LTE, I'm not able to use App Store sometimes. Sites not opening and I'm not receiving WhatsApp messages on time until I'm connected with my Wi-Fi. So this is the worst update. I'd have to agree. It's not one of the greatest, that's for sure. Now, we'll talk about when we'll see the final or the next one soon. Again, I keep running into that same issue over and over and over, that LTE bug. So just to make sure that Apple is recognizing this, make sure you go into that feedback app and report it. That way they see a lot of them coming in and they'll prioritize that. Usually they prioritize data, instead of other bugs. They want the data to work first. I'm using an iPhone 6S and it seems great overall, but there are some minor UI bugs that should be ironed out before the final release. Like if you're messing with privacy settings and go to turn off Find My Phone and cancel, sometimes it doesn't work as expected. Also, I've had it where turning down the volume does not turn it all the way down in some apps and leaves it at one square level. Minor hiccup here, but overall pretty good. It's been great on my iPhone XS Max. The only issue is it's occasionally lag, but it's not bad to the point where I say, okay, some bugs. Overall, it's really smooth. Battery life has been an amazing. That's really amazing. 8.5 to 9 hours. Is that screen on time that you're getting that? That's incredible if it is. Left iPhone for a Note 9 and haven't been happier. Now, as far as you saying this, I don't know that it's any difference on a Note. That's just as expensive. And yes, you get a lot of features, but I find they don't usually work as well and don't have support over the long term. It's just my experience. I have Android phones as well. I'm unable to use LTE on an iPhone SE. And like I said, this covers all of these older devices. So that's pretty typical this time around that LTE is just not great. I'm using iPhone 12 on my iPod Touch. since 12.1.1 beta 2, certain apps stopped using cellular data. I'm just unable to use apps. And another one. So a lot of people having those same issues over and over and over. So it's unfortunate, but hopefully they'll update that either. Now, this week is Thanksgiving in the United States. So it's a holiday week on Thursday. And if we see an update, I would expect it later today or tomorrow. If not, we won't see one until the following week, probably, or maybe even Friday. We don't know at this point. But since this is a holiday on the 22nd, it's hard to say. Now, this is pretty close to final, other than those LTE bugs, I would say, based off the build number. It has an A at the end. And that means we'll probably see a final in a week or two. But I could be wrong about that, but I'm looking more forward to iOS 12.2, where they normally add more features. So we're not seeing a whole lot of features here other than some fixes with FaceTime that I've talked about already, and a UI redesign for that I've shown before, but that's really it for that. So let me know what you think and when you think the next one will be out in the comments below. Also, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.